Hi guys, welcome back. So here is my Redmi Note 5 Pro mobile. So I'll quickly go to settings in order to show you that this is really Redmi Note 5 Pro. So I'll quickly go to about phone. So here you can see my device is Redmi Note 5 Pro with 4GB RAM and 64GB internal memory. So we are going to root this mobile, but before rooting we have to make sure that first your bootloader should be unlocked. And in case if you don't know what is bootloader, then you please proceed on your own risk. And second thing is you need to have your PC and laptop along with you. So first we'll quickly open our browser and download the TWRP custom recovery. So we'll open twrp.me. So we'll quickly open the TWRP website. So here it is and I'll open it. And you don't have to worry about all these links and all the apps which I'm going to use. I'll give all the links in the description below. So here you can see, I'll open the menu and open devices. So here we can see a whole bunch of devices are mentioned. So we'll search our device, the Redmi Note 5 Pro. So here it is. I'll click. So here you can see this. The downloads available for Redmi Note 5 Pro is available on this page. So I'll go down to the download links and here I can see the TWRP recovery for Redmi Note 5 Pro is available. So I'll download it, but you don't have to do all these hassles guys. I'll give all the direct links in the description below. So by the way, here it is. I'll quickly download it. So it will automatically start downloading by now. And one thing I am going to tell you guys, that the way which I am going to tell you is not only applicable to this Redmi Note 5 Pro but all the mobiles. Just you have to download the recovery for your specific mobile model and version. Number two, we have to download the Magisk Manager. So I'll search Magisk Manager. So Magisk Manager is the software which actually installs the root for your device. And it's actually a generic software, it does not depend on device, it's for all device the same. So here the Magisk Manager website is there. So we'll click Magisk Manager website. So from here we can download the official latest version. So we'll go down in order to see, no thanks. We'll go down to download it. Here it is. I click this. Yes. So here we can see the latest 19.0 beta is available. So I'll click on this Magisk beta in order to download it. So this would be a zip file which we have to flash through our custom TWRP recovery which we have just downloaded first. So now these two files are about to be downloaded and we are cool. So next step is we have to go to our laptops and we have to do some of the steps. But before that, we have to do some other settings in our device also. So we have to enable the USB debugging. So for that, we have to go to our settings again. And here we have to see developer options. It should be there in the additional settings. Let's see. But you guys also would have seen that there is no option available for developer option. Why? Because we have to do first enablement of those developer options. So first we'll go to about phone and here we have to click this MIUI version for 7 times. So we'll click it on 7 times and now we are a developer. It's mentioned here. So now we'll go back again to the additional settings. So yes, here additional settings are there. We'll click it and now if we go below here we can see the developer options is there. So now we have to open the developer options. It's already enabled. And the next thing we have to do is we have to enable the USB debugging mode. So here you can see USB debugging option is there, so we have to enable it. So we'll enable it and click OK. It's asking for allow USB debugging and we'll say yes. So all the setup now has been done and we'll connect our USB cable to our laptops. And next thing we have to do is to do on our laptop. So we'll switch to laptop now. So now I'm on my laptop, and here you can see that Redmi Note 5 Pro is available in my device. Now what I'll do is I'll copy those two files which we have downloaded earlier to my laptop. So these are the two files, TWRP and Magisk. I'll copy both of these files. So we'll copy it and we'll paste it here. So this is just another folder in my laptop, but here you can see there is another file called as platform tools along with these two files. So this file has ADB and flash boot binaries for Windows. So this also I'll upload, and you can find the link in the description. We'll just extract it. So let it get extracted. So this has all the tools required in order to root your device. So if you open it, here you can see the fast boot is there, ADB is there, and all the developer softwares which are required to root are already available in this zip. So we'll open the command prompt here just to see that everything is working. So we'll quickly type ADB devices. So what this will do is it will make sure that the connection from your laptop or desktop to your mobile is properly done. And if it lists this device, this means that your laptop or desktop is able to recognize your Redmi Note 5 Pro or any other mobile which you have connected. And now we have to boot our mobiles in the fast boot mode. For that, you have to switch off the mobile first and press the volume down key and the power key together for some time. And once the Redmi logo opens, you leave the power key and keep holding the volume down key till the time this fast boot logo shows. Now we'll again switch back to our laptops. So here you have to type this command in order to check whether the device is connected to your fast boot mode or not. Fast boot space devices. So it will show your device. So here we can see this shows that 4F32100 is available for fast boot mode. Now everything is set up. Now we have to flash the TWRP. But first check whether our bootloader is unlocked or not. So we have to type fastboot OEM device info. And here if you see the second option, bootloader device unlocked true. This device unlocked true means the bootloader is unlocked. And if it says false, you do not proceed. And if it says true, then you proceed and type fastboot space boot and the TWRP image path which we have downloaded. So here it is. So we'll just drag and drop to get that path. And here it is, fastboot boot and the path of that TWRP recovery image. And we'll hit enter and then see the magic in our mobiles. So I'll hit enter, and meanwhile you see what the magic happens in our device. So keep on watching. So 1, 2, and there you go. For now the mobile has only been booted up with TWRP recovery, but it's not flashed yet, so we have to flash it again. So here we'll go to install image, we'll go to whatever directory you have downloaded it. For me it was micro SD card. And here we can go to install image, this option, and then here we can see this TWRP image is there. So we'll click it in order to flash it, and we have to install in recovery. So everything looks okay, and we'll swipe to flash it. So here it's flashing, and you can see image is flash completed. Now we have to root our device. For that we have to again go to install zip, and we have this magic zip. We'll select it and we'll select the reboot after installation. So this will root our device, and again we'll swipe to confirm flash, and I'll fast forward. So here you can see it's installing. So this is actually rooting our device. So it will take some time, and now the flash is completed and it's now restarting my device. So it will now restart. I'll fast forward it. So now the device is restarted, and if you see here, this Magisk manager is properly installed now. So let's open it to see. So everything looks cool and awesome till now. And here you can see Magisk is up to date, Magisk Manager update is available, but that's nothing to worry. Still the existing version also works. All the settings, everything is opening quickly. No problem till now, all the thing looks okay. So in order to verify whether we have rooted properly, I'll install this root checker. So we'll click on verify root. And here it's asking and we'll grant it. So there you go guys, thumbs up. If you appreciate my efforts, please hit the like button and give me a visit on the below platforms. Thanks again for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.